I'm Tim McEwen. I'm President and Chief Executive Officer of Initiatives Prince George, the Economic Development Authority for Prince George. We work in full partnership with a number of other agencies to build Prince George as a knowledge-based resource economy that's connected to the world. We look at Prince George in terms of it's not only being a city of 80,000 people, but we're nested within 250,000 people over a vast service region within northern British Columbia. In this month's edition of On the Move, we're looking at our submission to the Provincial Standing Committee on Finance and Government Services. We highlight three priorities that we would like to see the government proceed with in their February budget. The first is full funding for the Wood Design and Innovation Centre, which is a project that has been contemplated in three previous throne speeches, and we would like to see that move forward. Second of all is the Pine Pass. This is $135 million worth of strategic infrastructure improvements to the safety and technical aspects of that road that will help our supply and service businesses here in Prince George access the Peace gas fields, and with the prospect of the Site C clean energy project over the course of the current decade, it will also help our businesses realize some benefits from that as well. The third item that we are seeking from the assistance from the provincial government on is additional funding for items needed within the airport grounds at the Prince George Airport Authority. There are a number of additional items that are required in order to build the full product to attract the fuel and tech stop business and air cargo activity that we have been building over the past few years at our airport and environs. This month's edition of On the Move also talks about engineering in, for, and by Northern British Columbians, building on the successful experience of the Northern Medical Program, where we actually train 33 doctors out of the UNBC each year. There is a need for engineering for civil and mechanical disciplines, much as there is for the training of medical doctors here in Northern British Columbia. So over time, and particularly as we work towards having a Wood Design and Innovation Center built in Prince George, engineering disciplines in, for, and by Northern British Columbia are going to be a key aspect of programming for that building, but also for building the economy of the new north as we continue to build the resource-based economy here in Prince George and Northern British Columbia.
Hi, I'm Catherine Scouten, Vice President Economic Development with Initiatives Prince George. Right now is a really exciting time for Northern British Columbia and the province of BC as we look at the growth in lumber and pulp exports to China, and in particular the role of the transportation infrastructure here in Northern BC. Prince George positions itself as a knowledge-based resource economy connected to the world, and we're really seeing that connection to the world is resulting in jobs and economic activity here as we speak. For example, last month, at least 1,000 containers of lumber originated here in northern BC and were transferred to Chinese ports through Prince Rupert from the Prince George transload facility that was developed by CN here just 2 years ago. So it's an exciting time. We're excited to see that the transportation investments that have been made by the Port of Prince Rupert, by CN, by the province of BC, and by the city of Prince George are really starting to pay economic dividends to our community.
At the end of this week, I'll be joining John Gibson, the president and CEO of the Prince George Airport Authority, on a mission to China. This will be the third mission this year into the Chinese market. We have a long-standing memorandum of understanding with the China Federation of Logistics and Purchasing for marketing of our airport and environs to the Chinese market. So we will be continuing to build this relationship. We will be attending their AGM in Chengdu, China, and meeting with a number of other logistics, freight forwarders, and transportation providers who would or could identify with the opportunity that we have here at Prince George, with the Prince George Airport Authority, with the Prince George Global Logistics Park, and the transportation hub that we have built with the CN Transload facility here.